My mama used to say, son, you're gonna grow up to be an honest man one day. She kept repeating it over and over till it was the last thing she said to me before she died on a cold winter's day in Chicago. That was her dream for me, not doctor or astronaut, just an honest man, a good man. Seems like a simple wish, the kind any mother would have for her son. But in my business, nothing is simple, and nothing is what it seems.
Going on?
You're gonna have to leave for a while, honey.
What are you talking about?
Take the truck and drive to Tulsa Airport. There's a ticket waiting for you at the United counter. A 9:55 to LA. When you get there, wait for me.
He's found us, hasn't he?
I got a plan.
Bill, I love you. I really do. But all your plans turn to shit.
Oh, come on.
Well, your life is on the line now, and I can't believe you're just gonna sit here and let it ride. You have gotta come with me. I need you.
I'm gonna be all right. We both are. Trust me, huh? Will you? Be all right. Everything's gonna be all right.
In the morning, and it's already 95 degrees in the damn city.
Will you look at you? Letting you carry a gun around and everything. Hey, tell Superfly here I never pack heat. You know that.
Yeah, and I never thought you turned rat either. Look at this place. I mean, you think after screwing over someone like the skipper, the feds at least give you a place that was, you know, civilized.
Have you been doing word building programs? That's a boner of a word for you, Felix. All right, Felix, you're the talker. The guy with the gun to my head's the shooter. Gotta have a driver outside, so who's Mr. Tooltime here?
It'd be nice to see his Royce. He's English. He has a thing for bad manners.
I can tell, by the way, he's tidying up my kitchen.
Yeah. Where's the little lady?
She's out of town.
Oh! Now, I'm gonna ask you one more time, Bill. Where's Deborah?
She went to Tulsa. She goes there once a week to get her hair done and catch a movie.
Well, let's check out the upstairs.
You know, I don't eat that shit myself. It's PMS food for my wife. I hear it makes you impotent.
Bill the Mouth Minucci. I've heard a lot about you. Always wanted to meet you. But now that I have, I've got to say, you don't look like shit to me.
Such a little hostility here, Royce.
Where's that shark can? Very bad. It's going to be a hundred.
You almost done?
In a minute. All right.
Let the man eat, Felix. I mean, for Christ's sake, he's from England. This is practically a gourmet meal for him. Besides, just being that ugly must work up one hell of an appetite.
What a come down, Bill. I mean, you used to be king of the night. Made sure the skipper had his hand in every juke joint and crack den in Chicago. I mean, you had the first class all the way. So what happened?
Well, it's like this, Felix. You know, you start to realize that the world's not a freak show. People change.
Evolve. Yeah, well, maybe here in Green Acres, but not in my world.
Who the fuck do you think you're talking to, huh? I was the one who brought you in the skipper's organization to begin with. Don't forget that. So don't give me your philosophical bullshit. I know you too well. You're about as deep as a jello shot.
Ain't here.
Well, I hope you kissed her goodbye, Bill.
Come on, Royce, you ready or what?
Come on, hey, come on! Hey, Shaft, you know, this is the new South. You're allowed to talk now.
Shut the fuck up.
Then if you don't have anything nice to say,
yeah, well, see, when you betrayed the skipper, Bill, you caused a lot of pain. Took a lot of cannon fire to protect his ass from the feds. A lot of your homeboys got new cribs and exciting new jobs, like picking up trash on the side of highways. But that wasn't enough for you. You had to go and piss on the skipper, messing with his money.
Felix, I wasn't messing with it. I flat out stole it.
Did you have?
Yeah.
And now you get to tell us, baby, where's that?
Where's the most dangerous place in the world? Statistically speaking.
Your asshole?
Oh, yeah, that's very funny, yeah. Come on, just off the top of your head.
Hello. New York, L.A.
I knew it. Everybody says either New York or Los Angeles. That's what I love about all you Yanks. You're all so bloody predictable.
The most dangerous place in the world is not a city. It is right here in your own twee little home.
I mean, who needs guns and bombs, eh? When you have got yourself hammers, chisels, screwdrivers, fishing wire, and power tools. Well, let's have a look then. I fancy the half-inch bit. What do you think, mate?
In your case, it sounds about right.
Or does it?
Christ, you know, I don't want to be a killjoy here, all right, guys? But don't you think you screw up should be escorting me out of here right about now?
Don't go jumping the gun, Bill. First things first.
Where's the skipper's dosh?
I don't have it.
Wrong answer.
Where's the money?
All right.
Where's the fucking money?
Fuck it! fuckers with me.
Shit. They send assholes like you to Australia.
Come on, come on.
Ow, your hands, your hands. Your hands are so smooth.
Whoa. Where's the dog at?
Why, you want to do a little
carpenter work on his ass too, Felix? Well, you're too late. Truck pancaked him.
He was a good dog, too. A lot like you, Felix. You know, real stupid, but loyal.
Yeah? Well, I'd rather be stupid than dead.
Where the hell you been, man? I've been sitting out here. If you told me we were gonna go on a trip so I could fry my ass, I would've... What's he still doing all right?
They asked me to come out here and give you a few fashion tips, Fredo.
Drive, man. Drive.
What the hell happened, man? I thought we were supposed to come down here and whack him.
Do you see any money? Because we don't do shit till we get the money.
Did he just say whack him? You know, I understand the skipper mixing up his crews and all, Felix, but when the hell did he start slumming with these third-rate Goomba wannabes?
Don't worry about Nick. He's about as Italian as Pizza Hut.
Hey, let me give you a word of advice there, Nico. Remember, you work for the skipper, and when he decides you're obsolete, guess whose ass gets whacked next?
What the fuck do you know about the skipper, man?
He don't know shit. Nobody's ever seen him.
Well, I have. Saw him and his girl.
Bullshit. Lives on some yacht someplace circling the globe.
Okay, check it out. Bing, 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 I get this call to drive the stretch, pick up some chick and take her to this private airstrip, right? So when she gets out, there's this old guy waiting for her in front of this jet. And he's holding this umbrella. And he's got this faggoty-ass rat dog, you know, like one of them runt greyhounds. You know, you can see his ribs and shit.
It's called a whippet, dipshit.
I'll fucking kill him! Fumes, man.
You gotta be kidding me.
Oh, God, you're good.
Didn't you know you're supposed to fill up the getaway car before you go ice to Mark?
Smiley ass piece of shit!
Drive, man! Drive!
I'm driving.
This is really special, Felix. Between affirmative action, foreign exchange, and your idiot flunky wise guy here, I've seen roadkill that lasts longer than these jokers.
What was that, Billy Boy? Couldn't quite hear you back then.
Fuck you, Fredo.
Bill's upset, Billy Boy's upset. What are we gonna do? What's the matter? He's upset. Fuck.
Would it matter at all if I should go away?
Color up.
Yep.
Want me to check the oil, too?
I ain't paying a dime extra.
All part of the service.
Yeah? Just don't go screwing something up and then trying to charge me for it.
Nick.
Hey, wait a minute. Hear me out, man. Hear me out. Come on. I don't suppose Felix told you about how much money I managed to acquire from the skipper when I was working for him, did he? Huh? I'm talking 3 commas, 6 zeros, and a 12 in front of it.
He's getting $12 million running numbers and laundering money.
And guns, and broads, and drugs. What can I say? It's a cash business. There's a hell of a lot of secret sauce. Listen, that's $12 million. Okay, we split that 3 ways. That comes to $4 million apiece, cash. All you gotta do is let me walk. Come on, what do you say? What do you think?
You move, you die.
What the fuck is this?
Some redneck crap.
Oh, shit. Shit!
It's just a local cop, so drink your crap, cool yourself, and let me handle this.
Sure.
All right.
fellas doing today?
Oh, can't complain. You know, just trying to stay cool, Chef.
How do... How you supposed to open this thing?
Let me show you a little trick. Grab it by the neck, and you twist hard.
What the hell are they doing?
Calm down, Royce. Felix can handle it.
Felix couldn't handle his own dick if it was spot welded to his hand.
Guess you fellas ain't from around here.
What the hell gave us away? Wait, don't tell me. It's the rings and shit. Am I right? Huh? Right?
All I'm trying to say is why they're out there talking to Barney Fife. Think about it. It's $12 million. That's real money I'm talking about. The only decision you gotta make is which one of us is gonna drive us the hell out of here.
Shit. We're dead. We're dead. The cop is a stonewall. He's found a way to haul our asses, and I know it.
All right. That's it.
Get out.
Fucking take care of him, Royce.
Royce!
Oh, this ought to be good.
See, Harmon is the heart of Sweetwater County. But the heart's only got one artery, and that's the highway.
Okay.
Used to be on telegraph. Now you get on that, you'll get your ride on back to the interstate. It's the only way.
You hear that, Royce? We ain't lost after all. That's a moon pie. Sheriff Dex here swears by him. Well, it's been nice talking to you, Sheriff.
Likewise.
Stay cool, man.
Y'all take it easy now.
All right, man.
Keep it changed.
Do you think you're a fucking asshole? Get the fuck out of the car like that.
Conley out there.
Conley?
Go ahead, boss. What you got?
I'm out of state bait for you.
All right. What state?
Illinois.
Ooh, the land of Lincoln.
Always did hate that son of a bitch. You want me to warm up the radar?
Conley, do not warm up the radar. Just track him. And keep your distance.
Say to my boys, Bill. They're so quiet, it's like you kicked them in the nuts.
Well, actually, if you're starting for accuracy, they kicked me in the nuts.
Yeah, he was just talking the same old shit he's been talking about all morning.
Okay, I give up. I admit it. I offered to split the money with him if they let me walk. You should have heard him too, Felix. How much? What does $12 million even look like? Could I get mine in pounds? How should we kill Nick and Felix? Slit their throats or shoot them in the head? You know, I suggested they flip for.
This piece of shit is playing us.
Oh, come on, he's denying it. He's denying it, Felix. Fucking lying!
Wait, you son of a
come
bitch!
Come on, man!
Fucking lying! Hey, come on, get up! Get off the road, man! Get off the road, man!
Get that damn thing out of sight and stay with it.
Oh, what the... Man! Stay with the van. Your fucking brains out, you son of a bitch. Stay with the van. Stay with the van. Shit.
Mm-hmm.
Stay with the fucking band, Nick.
You want to tell me what you think you're doing there, mister?
Sorry, officer. Just couldn't hold it anymore, you know? That redneck crap goes right through you.
You know, we got a law in the state against urinating in public.
In public? Way out here, 100 miles this side of Mayberry? You gotta be kidding me, man. Listen, officer, this is about some sort of fine. Well, I just, make amends and, we can both be on our way, you know? Know what I mean?
Boy, I sure as hell hope you ain't trying to bribe me. Show me the goddamn license.
It's in the van.
Go get it.
Okay.
Freeze right there, boy!
Jesus.
Don't move!
Look,
put your hands up on the van! High up!
Look, officer, if this is about that gun, I can explain
Carly,
everything.
Carly, that van come by here.
Less than you boys are revenue agents, you best stop right there.
We're looking for a man. His name is Bill Minucci. Maybe you've seen him?
What do you want with him?
That's sort of a personal matter. We don't want any trouble, just the man.
You boys got a little blood to you going deep.
You ask a science experiment, you call a son lighten up on the gun a little, huh?
Oh, that's much better. Thank you. We'd be glad to take him off your hands if you want.
I don't think you boys exactly seem to understand what's going on here.
You two know each other?
Yeah, well, Kyle and I are what you call business associates, right, Kyle?
Well, well. How the mighty fall. Bill Minucci, a fucking moonshiner.
Yeah, boy. This ain't nothing but some homebrew.
He's being way too modest. Boys, you just entered into the second largest crystal meth lab in the whole damn county.
See, I was kind enough to loan this sumbitch some money out of goodness of my heart. Since then, I ain't seen dollar one in return.
Some things never change, huh, Billy boy?
Kyle, I told you I'm gonna get that money back to you. I swear, you don't understand how that pyramid thing works. It's got a bill. It's an investment. In the meantime, don't you think you should be looking out for your goddamn investment? Well, if it isn't Mod Squad meets Deliverance.
Okay, everybody, let's just relax now. Take it real fucking easy. I'm sure we can work out some kind of deal.
Oh, Kyle. What do you want with these jokers and their chump change? I got some real dough for you, man. You can have a piece of, like, $12 million cash money, Kyle.
Who are you talking about?
Felix, tell him.
Shut up, Bill.
Come on, Felix, tell him. Tell him what you're here for, Felix. Go ahead.
All right. You want me to take care of this? I mean, I really think I should take care of this.
Son, you think you can pull that trigger? Before my boy spread you out for fertilizer?
I'll take my chances.
What the fuck you guys paid? Oh, fuck!
Felix. That's what you came here to do. Just kill me. Just kill me. Do it. Go ahead, right here.
Oh, shit. Oh, you ungrateful piece of... Why the hell do you think I called you 2 days ago, huh? I was giving you a goddamn head start. And if you really do got 12 million around here someplace, what the fuck are you doing skimming dimes from Pappy Yoakum back there?
There ain't a drug dealer that I care enough about not to steal the damn money.
Oh, man, you're unbelievable. I mean, all I know is that I gave you the heads up, Bill. All right? At least I was loyal.
Yeah, you're loyal, Felix. You're so damn loyal that when I wouldn't give you a bigger cut of what I was skimming, you had to go and call the skipper, didn't you?
What choice did I have?
You always have a choice, Felix. You want your steak medium or rare? Take a little off the top or trim the side? Do I want chocolate or vanilla? Shit, they'll even soft swirl it together for you for those days when you're really fucking confused. You always have a choice. And I made a choice not to sell you out to the feds.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And I warned you that we were coming. All right? So I say we even.
Oh, so I guess you're not gonna have a problem killing me once you get the money back, huh?
I wouldn't waste one fucking iota of time.
You're an asshole.
Which way to the money, Bill?
All right, don't be an asshole. It's on the other side of the road there. Back there. Okay?
Wait, but how do I know this ain't more of your lying-ass bullshit?
Well, you don't have a choice now, remember?
Connie, those boys come by yet?
I guess no SOS calls for you today.
God damn it, Connie, where the hell are you?
Connie, if you're out there sleeping again, I'm gonna rip you a whole new asshole.
Have you gone fucking mental?
Nick's got the keys.
I believe we have just been deputized.
Tracking game with that damn radar gun of yours.
You gotta believe me, I'm telling you the honest God truth.
Look, man, I don't know what he's talking about. He's nuts.
That's bullshit. He was trying to kill me. He's got a gun stuck in the back of his pants right there. Go on, Felix. Show the man. Show him how happy I am to see him.
Shut up!
Now get on your knees. Slowly.
It's talking to you, Felix.
If I have to say it again, I start blowing off heads. And if you don't think I will, you just ask the buck that's hanging on my wall.
God, dude.
I'm cooperative. Oh, Sheriff, you got a good instinct for bad guys. He's a bad guy. I'm a good guy. I mean, look at that tie. It's a dead giveaway.
Shut up!
We're your friends from the gas station.
Look, man, we kind of got lost on our way to the interstate.
Yeah. Well, you must have shit for brains, boy, because I give you pretty clear directions. I've seen you around.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, you have.
Yeah. You live out in the old Wilson place, don't
you? Yeah, sir, that's what I've been trying to tell you. You see, I'm a transplant. Transplanted here by the U.S. government. That sweet Uncle Sam put me here as a reward for helping out and serving my country. You gotta call the feds. You gotta believe me.
I don't gotta believe Jack.
Okay,
keep your eyes out for Bill.
Are you sick or something? Listen, as far as I'm concerned, this road trip is well over, mate. We should have finished him off back at the house.
It's not over till we find him.
All right, Mr. Do, right? Yeah, whatever you say. Just let me know where you want me to drop you off, all right? Because I ain't sticking around this shithole.
Skipper's paid us to do a job. He's not going to be happy if we come back without his money.
Oh, sweet Jesus Christ. How many fucking cops can one town have?
Calmly, son of a bitch. There you are. What the?
So we're smarter. I hope the hell you didn't get him a green card.
Shut the fuck up.
They're catching up. That concerns you at all.
Driving.
Give it up. Look, he may be a total wanker, but he's got more lives than a bloody cat.
Yeah, well, he couldn't have gotten far.
You Americans are unbelievable, aren't you? You actually believe in this never say die shit. The rest of the world just think you're totally fucking stupid.
Hey, what are you doing? You can't just walk away from one of the skipper's jobs.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'll tell you what. If I run into this Billy boy of yours, I'll kill him for you. How's that?
What about Felix?
Fuck him. He can take care of himself. Cheerio.
Asshole.
Go!
Cheerio, motherfucker.
I think your arms are broke. Just stay still if I was you.
Help me, man.
Hang tough, buddy. We'll have you out of there in 2 shakes. So you want to tell me why you were trying to kill your friend back there?
I wasn't. Just get me out of here.
Hey, I'll get you out, but you gotta work with me first.
Look, I'll tell you whatever you want to know. Just get me to a doctor.
Now, I don't think you're listening to me, boy. See, here's how it's gonna go. I ask you a question and you give me an answer. Understand?
No, I don't understand. Just get me out. God.
Now, do you understand? Why were you trying to kill your friend back there?
He stole some money from a man in Chicago.
How much?
Okay! 12 million!
And that's a powerful amount of money. I don't suppose he opened the savings account, did he? So where is it?
I don't know.
There's 2 things a man in your situation needs to be made aware of. This car's gas tank's leaking something fierce, and I'm dying for a Marlboro.
I told you I don't know!
Yeah. Here, try that Nicorette crap. But I gotta tell you, there's nothing like that first drag. Pulling that smoke into your lungs and holding it down tight like some little thing on prom night.
Come on, officer, this shit ain't funny! Look, Billy's got a hit, need to tell me where. I'm telling you the God's honest truth, please.
Well, guess if he didn't tell you. This conversation's over.
You can't just leave me here. I swear to God, that's all I know. What the hell can I come by you?
The kind that can kick a bad habit.
No! Sorry, sons of a bitches. I was just along for the ride.
And you sure took the wrong ride, boy. Release them dogs.
give me one reason why I shouldn't pull this trigger right now.
Hello.
I'll give you two. First, my gun is bigger. Second, because I'm an undercover agent. Special Agent Coltrane, FBI.
Oh, that's bullshit!
Be smart, Bill. Be smart for once in your life.
All right. If you're FBI, then why didn't you warn me the crew was coming?
I've been under 2 years deep cover trying to get the skipper.
Well, there's a little invention. Maybe you heard of it? Called a telephone!
Which part of deep cover don't you understand? I don't have regular contact with the Bureau. I didn't even know where we were going until I got in that van.
Bullshit! You're lying to me!
I didn't know, all right?
No, it's not all right! I'm hanging by my foot by a fucking tree! Wonder who the hell's gonna try to kill me next! What's my protection number?
325 Henry 78.
Shit! You bastards. Witness protection, my ass. You feds couldn't hide shit.
You know what, Bill? Fuck you, man.
No, fuck you!
No, fuck you!
Fuck you!
Fuck you and your smart mouth and your bullshit schemes! As I recall, the evidence you gave the Bureau didn't get us within 10 miles of the skipper.
Yeah, here's a tip. Tell your people to hire real accountants. I mean, kindergartens and calculators can do better than those jackass yahoos.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But I bet they still couldn't have found the $12 million you stashed away, huh, Bill?
I think that money was my retirement fund and none of your business. Besides, nobody asked me.
Well, now I'm asking. Where's the money?
Oh, yeah. Like you're gonna cut me a fucking deal, right? You don't give a shit about me.
Oh, you're right, Bill. I don't give a shit about you. But I will cut you a deal. Here's my deal. You take me to the money, and you might live to see tomorrow. I'll even get you back in the protection program. Otherwise, I'll just leave you hanging up there, like kibbles and bits.
Negotiation is definitely not your strong suit.
Yeah, well, I don't really think you're in a position to negotiate. I get the money, I use it to flush out the skipper. Now, your time's running out, Bill. Now, you do whatever you want. But the only other scenario I see panning out for you is your fat ass strapped to the hood of some redneck's pickup. Fine.
Okay, wait, come here. You gotta get me back to the house.
Fuck.
No, come on, I swear. Come on, don't be such an asshole. Just get me to the house, and I'll get you the money. Honest to God.
Trust me when I say this. You better not be lying to me.
What are you doing? Hey!
I was out. Thanks.
Sarah Jane, don't stare. It's not polite. I guess your luck ain't all bad today.
Well, starting to wonder until you came along.
Sarah Jane and I are due to drop off lunch for Conley here in town. After that, we'll take you where you're going, if that's all right.
Well, actually,
that'll be fine. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you kindly.
How's your husband, Darla?
Oh, you know Conley. He's fine.
Yeah, well, you know, being deputy sheriff and all, he's got a lot of responsibilities, don't he?
Oh, that ain't a hoot-nap. Nothing ever happens in Harmony, Billy Bob. You know that.
Now, you hear that, Miles? We're in safe hands here in Harmony.
Be right back. Oh, keep the windows down. Wouldn't want you to get sticky. Okay, hon.
Let me give you a tip, all right? Least you could have done is commandeer the damn vehicle.
Well, I'm commandeering your ass, okay? Now get the hell out. Move.
You're moody.
Conley? Dex? Anyone here?
So, Miles, why didn't you run into the station and embrace your brothers in law enforcement? Oh, I get it. Can't stop till you bring down the skipper, right? Get your picture plastered all over the TV, the book deal. In for the whole enchilada, are you, Miles?
You know, there's a lot more at stake in this operation than your punk ass, if that's what you're driving at. Besides Darla, well, she's not gonna find old Connelly at the station, because last I checked, he's dead.
Jesus Christ.
You wanna walk in there and explain how that little girl's father, the deputy sheriff of this town, happened to wind up face down in the dirt? Now you keep moving.
Anybody home? Conley?
Dex, right out.
Hi, Dex. Where's Mike Conley?
Oh, he's out on patrol.
Perfect. Oh, God, what happened to you?
Darla, this isn't a good time.
No, no.
Darla, we got ourselves a situation here. Got some criminal types running around the county stirring up God knows what kind of trouble.
Criminal types? They're in my car.
To your house on foot from here?
Oh, about 15, 20 minutes. But my Indian tracker's down at the reservation getting hammered on paint thinner, so I can't see for certain.
Well, we're gonna avoid the damn roads. I'm not interested in meeting any more cops or their immediate families.
You know, they'll probably charge you with an accessory of murder. But they won't give a shit if you're undercover or not.
Yeah? Well, recovering that money, bringing the skipper down, that's gonna forgive a lot of sins.
I don't know, a black man killing a white cop, unless you're a Heisman Trophy winner.
Well, how about a black man killing a white stoolie motor mouth by spraying his brains all over the cream corn because he won't shut the hell up?
Let me ask you a question. Who the fuck is Puff Daddy?
Billy Bob, that you? I haven't seen you around here for a while.
Well, Francis, how the hell are you? God, you're looking just beautiful today. Oh. What's going on with you?
Well, the darned ice cream freezer's on the blink again, and the Nutty Buddies are melting all over the damn place.
Well, you know, damn heat. You know, it's hard to keep that refrigeration going.
How's Deborah?
Well, you know Deborah. She goes down to Tulsa. She's down there getting her hair done now, catching a movie.
Billy Bob?
She ain't sweating it out like the rest of us.
I must say, Billy Bob, you look like you're doing a mite more than sweating.
Well, hell, you know what? She got a damn accident with that truck, and I'm trying to fix it myself, and look at me. I mean, I can't report it. My insurance can go sky high. You know that.
Who's your friend?
Danzel. This is Danzel.
Billy Bob, we gotta get out of here now.
You mind if I get a couple things to take with us? You like the jerky, don't you, Danzel? Huh? Hey, look what they got here. We got beef jerky, turkey jerky, goat jerky. We got rabbit jerky. What kind of jerky you like?
What the hell are you doing?
I am thirsty, Danzel. Let me get you something to drink, too. You look a little stressed. Hey! Look at this! This is great! You ever have this? This is just like Dr. Pepper, but without the medical degree.
That gonna be cash or charge, Billy Bob?
Damn, Deborah took all my money. I'm gonna have to charge it.
Well, you know the drill.
Yeah, no drill. Hey, let me ask you a question. What's the theory behind those fly strips? They're just sticky, right? The flies just fly right into their death?
Well, I don't know.
You know what? Why don't you order me some and ship them to the house? Hey, Francis? You ever hear Puff Daddy?
Is that a cereal?
Billy Bob, now?
You know what? It takes a little time here in the South. They're a little more hospitable than you are in that urban country.
We're way out there where the hoot owls are screwing the chickens.
How's that? Did I do that right? I'm always messing it up.
Put your hands up!
Oh, shit. Look, I don't know what he told you, but I'm...
He's going for his gun!
Okay, hold on! Just wait! I was just reaching for my ID. I'm a federal agent.
That bullshit! Bullshit!
You can get 20 to life just for pointing that thing at me.
He's lying! He's lying, Francis! He killed Connolly, and I was next. Ugh. He's got a gun. He's a killer, Francis. He's a killer of people.
Bill, you son of a... Francis, you are making the biggest mistake of your life.
Be that as it may, I think I'll just let Sheriff Dreyer sort it out.
That's right. You know what, Francis? I'll go call him right now.
Yeah, good idea.
You be careful. This man's a deadly man. Look at him.
Bill.
He's bad. Don't be afraid now to shoot him right in the head. He's scary. He's bad.
Bill.
Keep that gun on him.
Bill. Bill, this ain't gonna turn out the way you think. Bill! Bill!
Stay where you are.
Francis, now Billy Bob, he didn't call the sheriff.
Billy Bob, what's the good word back there?
Francis, he's gone, okay? He left. He went out back, got in your car, he found the keys you probably hide above the visor, and took off, leaving you in a shitload of trouble.
I hide my spare behind the wheel rim.
Well, excuse me for saying this, but that's about as smart as choosing 1234 as your PIN number. Francis Billy Bob is really Bill Minucci, an ex-con who's in a whole mess of trouble with the FBI. Now, do you want to be responsible for letting him get away? Do you? Now, listen to me, Francis. Now, one or two things can happen here. I can wrestle that gun away from you, and one of us could end up dead. Or you could just hand it over. Get into that cooler. I'll just lock you in there with all those half-frozen nutty buddies. But if you don't make up your mind fast, I'm gonna have to make it up for you.
You're not gonna try and rape me or anything, are you, Mr. Denzel?
Francis, I can honestly say the thought never even crossed my mind.
God, it's you. I was so scared.
What the hell are you doing here? You're supposed to be in L.A.
I missed my flight, and then when I drove back, I found the house like this.
Jesus.
It's the skipper, isn't it?
Listen, I'll tell you all about it when we're lying on a beach in Saint-Tropez sipping champagne, all right?
I thought you were dead. I thought I'd never see you again.
Come on, don't get all gushy on me. I told you I had a plan, didn't I? I may have hit a few potholes, but I'm still here, right? Right.
Bill, let's get the money and get out of here.
All right, all right. All right, go. You go downstairs, get in the truck, and wait for me. Hey, where is your truck?
It's over at my house.
About goddamn time you showed up. I ripped this place apart.
Well, put your clothes back in, baby. I came as fast as I could.
Jesus Christ.
Come on, Bill. Do you really think I was driving to Tulsa every week?
Well, yeah. I mean, your hair always looked nice. Does this mean you didn't see Titanic 40 times? I bought the CD and the video cassette. That video cassette was hard to get. I'll have to give it to my niece. How the hell could you?
It was easy. Strange how someone who spends his entire life lying to survive doesn't expect to be lied to. I could never trust you, Bill. Who could?
You had yourself a mighty fine slice of woman here, Bill.
Yeah.
Too bad you couldn't satisfy her. Guess it takes a country boy to plow such fertile soil.
Yeah, she must be a real step up for you. After all those years of plugging tree trunks with your dick.
I'm sick of your lip, boy! With this money I keep hearing so much about.
Tell me something, Deborah. Honestly, you think you and your deputy dog here can double-cross the skipper?
The only reason he found you was because this lady was kind enough to call him up and tell him where you were.
You called the skipper? Oh, that's beautiful. No, actually, that's a damn haiku.
I'm sorry, Bill. You settled. You pulled the plug. I can't get excited about growing old in this backwater hellhole. Neither can Dex. Can you, baby?
That's right, sugar. And the problem is I don't want to grow old with someone who lies to me.
What are you talking about?
You told me Bill here only stole $120,000.
Oh, you're rich. Oh, that's a knee slapper. Don't you think you left out a few zeros there, sugar?
Dex, I was gonna tell you.
I assure you I, sugar. Sure you were.
Jesus! Fucking animal!
See, the way I figure it, when the skipper fella hears that both of you are dead, that ought to be the end of it. Hell, I think I'm gonna buy myself a Van Gogh. You gonna tell me where the money is?
I don't need to tell you jack shit. The way I figure it, by the time you're done cleaning up this mess and burying all the bodies, you'll still be driving that pissant squad car, giving out parking tickets.
See, I know you got it buried around here somewhere. Otherwise, why'd you come back? Now, if it takes me a week, or a month, or a year, I'll find it. So you see, Bill, I don't really need you at all, do I? Be sure and say hi to Deborah for me.
You can open your eyes, Bill.
Miles. Miles. Oh, God, Miles, listen. I'm really sorry about what happened at the store, you know, with Francis. I mean, what can I do? Come on, let's talk. It's you and me. It's just you and me now.
I got the bullets and I got the gun. So no more games and no more bullshit. Now, where is it?
What's this pushing and shoving? What is this Mr. T bullshit, huh? What are you so uptight about? I'm the one who's got to live with the image of my wife getting shot in the head by the sheriff who was fucking her. OK, Okay, I'm over it. I'll take you to the money.
Get up.
You expecting a call?
Get the damn phone.
Coming. Hello?
You got to the count of 10 to show your face.
You got 3 guns, unless you can shoot with your phone.
God damn it, Bill, I'm not giving you a gun.
What, do you think I'm stupid enough to shoot a federal agent?
Matter of fact, yes, I do.
Come on!
You put that anywhere near me, I swear to God, you're DOA guaranteed.
I got a gun upstairs.
It was given to me by the skipper. I never use it unless it's absolutely necessary.
You mean the .38 taped above your toilet?
Oh, I found that this morning.
Next to the money? Joking, lighten up, come on!
You gonna get it?
What if it's my mother-in-law?
Get the phone!
Kind of hillbillies with cell phones.
Hello, this is Billy Bob. I'm sorry I can't get to the phone right now, but
hold on. Let me turn the machine on.
Hold on. Kyle, how are you? I'm sorry I couldn't pick up the phone earlier. I was busy having my ass shot off.
You know, it used to be you'd just come up and knock on the front door.
Tell me where the money is.
Now, you listen to me, you little fucking gomer. We had a goddamn deal. $150,000 in your compound to take him out. No questions asked.
You son of a bitch.
Now, I don't recall taping a shotgun to my head and opening negotiations with the guys I gave you money to kill as being part of the fucking deal, Kyle.
Well, how much you died wrong?
I must have got the goddamn psychic hotline.
Who's I'm talking to a dead man.
Asshole. Well, don't look at me like that. You came down here to kill me. It wasn't like you came down here for the nightlife.
Faster than he looks.
One more time. Ready?
Go.
Oh,
this mess. Even a guy like me gets tired of running. Besides, Deborah and I had plans. You golf?
No.
Like baseball?
No.
So much for male bonding. Hey, you like Dionne Warwick?
Yeah, I like her.
Yeah, she's good.
Yeah.
Big dummy.
Battery.
really sorry about that Gomer stuff back there. I was really under a lot of stress. I mean, my wife just got killed and all that gunfire. Hey, good news in that pyramid thing.
Who's your partner?
Him? Oh, he's dead. That no good cop bagged him back in town. He was trying to get him to tell him where the money was. But that money is yours. Mine, right?
Tell you what. I'll keep an eye out for it while I'm digging your grave.
Jesus. Oh, shit. Jesus, Miles. Miles, thank you for that. You know, you always show up at the right time. That son of a bitch is gonna kill me. You are a good man, Miles. What? What?
The money.
What's with the gun? Hey, we just kicked some redneck ass and I saved yours. Didn't you hear me? I told him you were dead. I told him that no good sheriff bagged him back in town. Jesus! What the fuck's that about?
The money. Now.
Huh? Come on, after all we've been through? I mean, this is a partnership. This is like Culp and Cosby, like Gibson and Glover, like Hootie and the Blowfish.
You know, you can't do this, Miles.
Shut up.
You're a damn federal officer. You know, I got certain rights no matter what. You remember that, man. You took an oath.
Come on, Bill. Where is it?
It's in there.
Get it.
It's right here.
Get it.
Get in there.
Careful, Bill. Very, very careful.
What the hell is this?
That's some money. I told you. Trusted you? Oh, shit! How did you know my protection number? Oh, I know. I know how you knew it. I didn't know it. You bullshitted me. You played the odds. Oh, you're good, man. You are good. You bluffed me. I believed you.
Yeah, well, you shouldn't believe everything you hear. You of all people should know that, Bill. Now, where's the money?
It never left Chicago.
You're lying to me, Bill!
Oh,
you're lying to me, and I'm tired of your bullshit! Where's the money?
I'm
gonna kill you, man. I'm gonna fucking kill you. Where's the money?
Jesus Christ! It's in Chicago. It's in a self-storage place in Chicago. DeSoto Storage. Ethan DeSoto. You think if I had the money here, I'd hang around this fucking shithole? I couldn't go to Chicago. I was stuck. I had to wait till I got rid of you bastards. I'm not fucking with you. My wallet. Get my wallet. Oh, you bastard. Take your photo out for me and Deborah. Turn it over. That was the boat we were going to buy and sail away on until you bastards came down here. You backstabbing son of a bitch.
Well, sure is nice to see that you can tell the truth when you have the proper motivation, Bill. Too bad you didn't have somebody around to shoot you every day.
Well, it's been a real pleasure meeting you after all these years. Gotta go.
What are you talking about? After all these years? Who are you? Oh, that's my lucky gun.
The one the skipper gave me.
I never use it unless I absolutely
have to. I know.
Who the hell are you?
Mama always said, sometimes it takes a miracle to save some people. God knows Mama prayed for a miracle, but it never came. At least not for me. Never did find that money, but not a day goes by when the thought of it doesn't burn right through me. Maybe Bill spent it all, or maybe he gambled it away. Whatever he did, I guess you've got to admire a man who can look death in the face and still tell you a stone-cold lie.
Come on.
Back in the States with this pyramid.
Get that damn thing out of sight and stay with it.
Oh, what the? Man!
Stay with the van.
Your fucking brains out, you son of a bitch.
Stay with the van. Stay with the fucking van.
Shit, shit, shit!
You want to tell me what you think you do there, mister?
Sorry, officer. Just couldn't hold it anymore, you know? That redneck crap goes right through you.
Uh-huh. You know, we got a law in the state against urinating in public.
In public? Way out here, 100 miles this side of Mayberry? You gotta be kidding me, man. Listen, officer, this is about some sort of fine. Well, I just, make amends and, we can both be on our way, you know? Know what I mean?
Boy, I sure as hell hope you ain't trying to bribe me. Show me the goddamn license.
It's in the van.
Go get it.
Okay.
Freeze right there, boy! Don't move!
Look,
put your hands above the van! Hide up!
Officer, if this is about that gun, I can explain
Tommy,
everything.
Tommy, that van come by yet?
Less than you boys are revenue agents, you best stop right there.
We're looking for a man. His name is Bill Minucci. Maybe you've seen him?
What do you want with him?
That's sort of a personal matter. We don't want any trouble, just the man.
You boys got a little blood feud going, do you?
You ask a science experiment, you call a sun lighting up on the gun a little, huh? Oh, that's much better. Thank you.
We'd be glad to take them off your hands if you want.
I don't think you boys exactly seem to understand what's going on here.
You two know each other?
Yeah, well, Kyle and I are what you call business associates, right, Kyle?
Well, well. How the mighty fall. Bill Minucci, a fucking moonshiner.
Yeah, boy. This ain't nothing but some homebrew.
He's being way too modest. Boys, you just entered into the second largest crystal meth lab in the whole damn county.
She asked kind enough to loan this sumbitch some money out of goodness of my heart. Since then, I ain't seen dollar one in return.
Some things never change, huh, Billy boy?
Kyle, I told you I'm gonna get that money back to you. I swear, you don't understand how that pyramid thing works. It's got a bill. It's an investment. In the meantime, don't you think you should be looking out for your goddamn investment? Well, if it isn't Mod Squad meets Deliverance.
Okay, everybody, let's just relax now. Take it real fucking easy. I'm sure we can work out some kind of deal.
Look, Kyle. What do you want with these jokers and their chump change? I got some real dough for you, man. You can have a piece of, like, $12 million cash money, Kyle.
Who are you talking about?
Felix, tell him.
Shut up, Bill.
Come on, Felix, tell him. Tell him what you're here for, Felix. Go ahead.
All right. You want me to take care of this? I mean, I really think I should take care of this.
Son, you think you can pull that trigger? Before my boy spread you out for fertilizer?
I'll take my chances.
What the fuck you guys think? Oh, fuck!
Thank you.
You almost done? In a minute, all right.
Let the man eat, Felix. I mean, for Christ's sake, he's from England. This is practically a gourmet meal for him. Besides, just being that ugly must work up one hell of an appetite.
Down, Bill. I mean, you used to be king of the night. Made sure the skipper had his hand in every juke joint and crack den in Chicago. I mean, you had the first class all the way. So what happened?
Well, so I guess, Felix, you know, you start to realize that the world's not a freak show. People change.
Evolve.
Yeah, well, maybe here in Green Acres, but not in my world.
Who the fuck do you think you're talking to, huh?
I was the one who brought you into Skipper's organization to begin with. Don't forget that. So don't give me your philosophical bullshit. I know you too well. You're about as deep as a jello shot.
She ain't here.
Well, I hope you kissed her goodbye, Bill.
Come on, Russ. You ready or what?
Come on. Hey, come on.
Hey, Shaft. You know, this is the new South. You're allowed to talk now.
Shut the fuck up.
Then if you don't have anything nice to say, I guess.
Yeah, well, see, when you betrayed the skipper, Bill, you caused a lot of pain. Took a lot of cannon fire to protect his ass from the feds.
A lot of your homeboys got new cribs and exciting new jobs, like picking up trash on the side of highways. But that wasn't enough for you. You had to go and piss on the skipper, messing with his money.
Felix, I wasn't messing with it. I flat out stole it.
Did you have?
Yeah.
And now you get to tell us, baby, where's that?
Where's the most dangerous place in the world? Statistically speaking.
Your asshole? Oh, yeah, that's very funny, yeah.
Come on, just off the top of your head.
Hello. New York, L.A.
I knew it. Everybody says either New York or Los Angeles. That's what I love about all you Yanks. You're all so bloody predictable.
The most dangerous place in the world is not a city. It is right here in your own twee little home.
I mean, who needs guns and bombs, eh? When you have got yourself hammers, chisels, screwdrivers, fishing wire, and power tools. Well, let's have a look then. I fancy the half-inch bit. What do you think, mate?
In your case, it sounds about right.
Or does it?
Christ, you know, I don't want to be a killjoy here, all right, guys? But don't you think you screw up should be escorting me out of here right about now?
Don't go jumping the gun, Bill. First things first.
Where's the skipper's dosh?
I don't have it.
Wrong answer.
Where's the money?
All right.
Where's the fucking money?
Silly buckets with me.
Shit. Let me send assholes like you to Australia.
Come on.
Ow, your hands.
Your hands are so smooth.
Whoa. Where's the dog at?
Why, you want to do a little carpenter work on his ass too, Felix? Well, you're too late. Truck pancaked him.
He was a good dog, too. A lot like you, Felix. You know, real stupid, but loyal.
Yeah? Well, I'd rather be stupid than dead.
Where the hell you been, man? I've been sitting out here. If you told me we were gonna go on a trip so I could fry my ass, I would've... What's he still doing over there?
They asked me to come out here and give you a few fashion tips, Fredo.
Drive, man. Drive.
What the hell happening, man? I thought we were supposed to come down here and whack him.
Do you see any money? Because we don't do shit till we get the money.
Did he just say whack him? You know, I understand the skipper mixing up his crews and all, Felix, but when the hell did he start slumming with these third-rate Goomba wannabes?
Don't worry about Nick. He's about as Italian as Pizza Hut.
Hey, let me give you a word of advice there, Nico. Remember, you work for the skipper, and when he decides you're obsolete, guess whose ass gets whacked next?
What the fuck do you know about the skipper, man?
He don't know shit. Nobody's ever seen him.
Well, I have. Saw him and his girl.
Bullshit. Lives on some yacht someplace circling the globe.
Okay, check it out. Bing, 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 I get this call to drive the stretch, pick up some chick and take her to this private airstrip, right? So when she gets out, there's this old guy waiting for her in front of this jet, and he's holding this umbrella, and he's got this faggoty-ass rat dog, you know, like one of them runt greyhounds, you know, you can see his ribs and shit.
It's called a whippet, dipshit.
Oh, fucking kill him!
Damn, man!
What? We're on fumes, man.
You gotta be kidding me.
Oh, God, you're good.
Didn't you know you're supposed to fill up the getaway car before you go ice to Mark?
Spoily ass piece of shit!
Drive, man! Drive!
I'm driving.
This is really special, Felix. Between affirmative action, foreign exchange, and your idiot flunky wise guy here, I've seen roadkill that lasts longer than these jokers.
What was that, Billy boy? Couldn't quite hear you back there.
Fuck you, Fredo.
Bill's upset, Billy boy's upset. What are we gonna do? What's the matter? He's upset. Fuck.
Would it matter at all if I should go away?
Color up?
Yep.
Want me to check the oil, too?
I ain't paying a dime extra.
All part of the service.
Yeah? Just don't go screwing something up and then trying to charge me for it.
Nick.
Hey, wait a minute. Hear me out, man. Hear me out. Come on.
I don't suppose Felix told you about how much money I managed to acquire from a skipper when I was working for him, did he? Huh? I'm talking 3 commas, 6 zeros, and a 12 in front of it.
You skimmed $12 million running numbers and laundering money?
And guns, then broads, and drugs. What can I say? The cash business has a hell of a lot of secret sauce. Listen, that's $12 million. Okay, we split that 3 ways. That comes to $4 million apiece, cash. All you gotta do is let me walk. Come on, what do you say? What do you think?
You move, you die.
What the fuck is this?
Some redneck crap.
Shit. Shit!
It's just a local cop, so drink your crap, cool yourself, and let me handle this.
How are you fellas doing today?
Oh, can't complain. You know, just trying to stay cool, Chef.
How the... How you supposed to open this thing?
Let me show you a little trick. Grab it by the neck. And you twist. Hard.
What the hell are they doing?
Calm down, Royce. Felix can handle it.
Felix couldn't handle his own dick if it was spot welded to his hand.
Guess you fellas ain't from around here.
What the hell gave us away? Don't tell me. It's the rings and shit. Am I right?
Huh? Right?
All I'm trying to say is why they're out there talking to Barney Fife. Think about it. It's $12 million. That's real money I'm talking about. The only decision you gotta make is which one of us is gonna drive us the hell out of here.
Shit, shit. We're dead. We're dead. The cop is a stalwart. He's found a way to haul our asses, and I know it.
All right. That's it.
Get out.
Fucking take care of him, Royce.
Royce!
Oh, this ought to be good.
See, Harmon is the heart of Sweetwater County. But the heart's only got one artery, and that's the highway.
Okay.
Used to be on Telegraph. Now you get on that, we'll get you right on back to the interstate. It's the only way.
You hear that, Royce? We ain't lost after all. That's a moon pie. Sheriff Dex here swears by him. Well, it's been nice talking to your sheriff.
Likewise.
Stay cool, man.
Y'all take it easy now.
All right, man. Keep it changed.
Do you think you're being a fucking asshole? Get the fuck out of the car like this.
Connelly out there.
Connelly?
Go ahead, boss. What you got?
Some out-of-state bait for you.
All right. What state?
Illinois.
Ooh, the land of Lincoln.
Oh, he did hate that son of a bitch. You want me to warm up the radar?
Connelly, do not warm up the radar. Just track him. And keep your distance.
Say to my boys, Bill. They're so quiet, it's like you kicked them in the nuts.
Well, actually, if you're starting for accuracy, they kicked me in the nuts.
Yeah, he was just talking the same old shit he's been talking about all morning.
Okay, I give up. I admit it. I offered to split the money with him if they let me walk. You should have heard him too, Felix. How much? What does $12 million even look like? Could I get mine in pounds? How should we kill Nick and Felix? Slit their throats or shoot them in the head? You know, I suggested they flip for.
This piece of shit is playing us!
Oh, come on, he's denying it! He's denying it, Felix! Fucking lying!
Wait, you son of a
come
bitch!
Come on, man!
Fucking lying! Get off the road! Get off the road, man! Get off the road, man! Get off the road! Get off the road!
Stop this man! to kill me, Felix. That's what you came here to do. Just kill me. Just kill me. Do it. Go ahead, right here.
Oh, shit. Oh, you ungrateful piece of... Why the hell do you think I called you 2 days ago, huh? I was giving you a goddamn head start. And if you really do got 12 million around here someplace, what the fuck are you doing skimming dimes from Pappy Yoakum back there?
There ain't a drug dealer that I care enough about not to steal the damn money.
Oh, man, you're unbelievable. I mean, all I know is that I gave you the heads up, Bill. All right? At least I was loyal.
Yeah, you're loyal, Felix. You're so damn loyal that when I wouldn't give you a bigger cut of what I was skimming, you had to go and call the skipper, didn't you?
What choice did I have?
You always have a choice, Felix. You want your steak medium or rare? Take a little off the top or trim the side? Do I want chocolate or vanilla? Shit, they'll even soft swirl it together for you for those days when you're really fucking confused. You always have a choice. And I made a choice not to sell you out to the feds.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And I warned you that we were coming. All right? So I say we even.
Oh, so I guess you're not gonna have a problem killing me once you get the money back, huh?
I wouldn't waste one fucking iota of time.
You're an asshole.
Which way to the money, Bill?
All right, don't be an asshole. It's on the other side of the road there. Back there. Okay?
Wait, but how do I know this ain't more of your lying-ass bullshit?
Well, you don't have a choice now, remember?
Connie, those boys come by yet?
I guess no SOS calls for you today.
God damn it, Conley, where the hell are you?
Conley, if you're out there sleeping again, I'm gonna rip you a whole new asshole.
Have you gone fucking mental?
Nick's got the keys.
I believe we have just been deputized.
Tracking game with that damn radar gun of yours.
I'm with the Federal Witness Protection Program.
Put your hands in the air!
You gotta believe me, I'm telling you the honest God truth.
Look, man, I don't know what he's talking about. He's nuts.
That's bullshit. He was trying to kill me. He's got a gun stuck in the back of his pants right there. Go on, Felix. Show the man. Show him how happy I am to see him.
Shut up!
Now get on your knees. Slowly.
It's talking to you, Felix.
If I have to say it again, I start blowing off heads. And if you don't think I will...
You just ask the buck that's hanging on my wall.
God, dude.
I'm cooperative. Oh, Sheriff, you got a good instinct for bad guys. He's a bad guy. I'm a good guy. I mean, look at that tie. It's a dead giveaway.
Shut up!
We're your friends from the gas station.
Look, man, we kind of got lost on our way to the interstate.
Yeah. Well, you must have shit for brains, boy, because I give you pretty clear directions.
I've seen you around.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, you have.
Yeah. You live out in the old Wilson place, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, sir, that's what I've been trying to tell you. You see, I'm a transplant. Transplanted here by the U.S. government. That sweet Uncle Sam put me here as a reward for helping out and serving my country. You gotta call the feds. You gotta believe me.
I don't gotta believe Jack.
Oh, get up!
Keep your eyes out for Bill.
Are you sick or something?
My mama used to say, son, you're gonna grow up to be an honest man one day. She kept repeating it over and over till it was the last thing she said to me before she died on a cold winter's day in Chicago. That was her dream for me, not doctor or astronaut, just an honest man, a good man. Seems like a simple wish. The kind any mother would have for her son. But in my business, nothing is simple. And nothing is what it seems.
Going on?
You're gonna have to leave for a while, honey.
What are you talking about?
Take the truck and drive to Tulsa Airport. There's a ticket waiting for you at the United Counter. The 9:55 to LA. When you get there, wait for me.
He's found us, hasn't he?
I got a plan.
Bill, I love you. I really do. But all your plans turned to shit.
Oh, come on.
Well, your life is on the line now, and I can't believe you're just gonna sit here and let it ride. You've gotta come with me. I need you.
I'm gonna be all right. We both are. Trust me. Huh? Will you? Be all right. Everything's gonna be all right.
3 o'clock in the morning and it's already 95 degrees in the damn shade.
Will you look at you? Letting you carry a gun around and everything. Hey, tell Superfly here I never pack heat. You know that.
Yeah, and I never thought you turned rat either. Look at this place. I mean, you think after screwing over someone like the skipper, the feds at least give you a place that was, you know, civilized.
Have you been doing word building programs? That's a boner of a word for you, Felix. All right, Felix, you're the talker. The guy with the gun to my head's the shooter. Gotta have a driver outside, so who's Mr. Tooltime here?
Pretty nice, this here's Royce. He's English, he has a thing for bad manners.
I can tell by the way he's tidying up my kitchen.
Yeah, 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 where's the little lady?
She's out of town.
Oh! Now I'm gonna ask you one more time, Bill. Where's Deborah?
She went to Tulsa. She goes there once a week to get her hair done and catch a movie.
Well, let's check out the upstairs.
You know, I don't eat that shit myself. It's PMS food for my wife. I hear it makes you impotent.
Bill the Mouth Minucci. I've heard a lot about you. Always wanted to meet you. But now that I have, I've got to say, you don't look like shit to me.
Such a little hostility here, Royce.
Where's that sarcasm? Just hear me, Dad.